Hello everyone, welcome to Home Life Essence. This is Namrata and I'm gonna take you to the journey of simplifying, organizing and beautifying your space and your life. Considering current situation, I think it's a perfect time to talk about your medicine cabinet organization. I think organizing, it shouldn't overwhelm you. It should be easy and practical as well. That is what I'm following here too. Firstly, I'm taking out all the medicines and stuff out of my medicine cabinet. Here, I haven't used any special organizing stuff or fancy container. I use whatever I have or whatever was readily available. Now, coming to the equipments. Like we have nebulizer and heating pad. You keep all these equipments in a bag in which they come. And keep all the extra accessories and cords in that same bag itself so that you don't have to look for it when you actually need them. Plus the medicines that you need for that, like it's a nebulizer, so we need nebulization liquid. You keep it in the same bag so that it comes handy when you actually need it. These might be some electrical equipment, so you need to keep them protected from all the moisture and rust. So that's why it's always good to keep it in this kind of bags, kind of clear plastic boxes to store these strips of tablets and capsules. And you always label these boxes. Either you may label it with a type of medicine if you have a specific medicine for a particular ailment, or you may label it with the name of patient. I always keep this kind of pad and paper in my medicine cabinet, in which I'll keep record of all the medicines that we have in this kind of tabular form, like medicine name, its type and expiry date. Like name of medicine, whether it's a kind of anti-allergic or antihistamine or whatever it is, along with its expiry date, so that I'll have a clear record of what are types of all the medicines that we have and when I need to throw them away. Here on a separate page, I am writing down all the medicines which are currently out of stock and that I need to buy. I am writing it down on a paper so that I can carry it in my bag. Or you may note it down in your mobile. And never forget to check for expiry dates of your medicines and discard them timely and refill the stock. I'm using this kind of plastic boxes to store all these ointments and the saline rinse that we have. In another box, we use certain Ayurvedic medicines. So I'm keeping all these Ayurvedic medicines, and these medicines is always comes with a kind of note, like for what this medicine is and what are the doses that we have to take. And I always store these medicines along with this kind of note with it. It's always better to use a separate box for storing kids' medicines. So all these are cough syrup and paracetamol and all the medicines that we use for our daughter. The droppers, the dropper with measurement, and this is the cute box for storing her colorful plasters. If you want, you may name or label this box with name too.
Here I am using an unused ice cream container to store some of the medicated cosmetics that I use. Along with that, I have some extra vitamins that we have in stock. I prefer to keep this kind of empty travel bag in my medicine cabinet. this kind of bag, it comes very handy whenever we need to travel. We just need to refill it with the essential medicines and pack it with our stuff. And don't forget to keep some extra Ziploc bags with you.
And your first aid box and some medicines that must be kept in your bedside table that I'm keeping in a separate container. It's better to line this container if you have a kind of spillage. So here I'm keeping a hand sanitizer, your Vicks, paracetamol, pain relief spray, some plasters, cotton, burn ointment, eye or ear drop if you have, and earbuds. So all these things, it will go into my bedside table along with this one more box in which I have pain relief spray, some gauze bandage, and not to forget thermometer.
And now some of the medicines and vitamins that we have to take on daily basis, I prefer to keep them in a tray on dining table. Like these days, we are taking vitamin C, vitamin D, and Eno kind of stuff. So you will find this kind of tray always on my dining table.
I prefer to keep this kind of file folder to store all the medical files and insurance papers, if you have, and insurance cards, so that all these things will be at one place when you need them. This is the medicine cabinet that I'm using. So I need to arrange the things. I'm starting with least used things first. Like firstly, I'm keeping this travel medicine bag. Then heat pad. Then comes nebulizer.
Then comes all the stocked vitamins that we'll be using later. Then I'm gonna keep this all the boxes. It's almost organized, so just I need to arrange the boxes only.
And here comes the last box. I'm keeping this pad in this folder itself. And here comes this medical file folder here. And these two boxes that we talked about, they are gonna go into a bedside table.
And this is all for today, guys.